I'm Sachalila.
And I'm Diva.
And we're sitting in Divan's living room, where we've had quite a few hours of conversation over the last year or two about Sangharakshita's complete works. We've both got very enthusiastic about it, and we've started running sessions in Bristol to enthuse our friends.
So we're making this video to share our enthusiasm for the Complete Works project, to encourage others to engage, to read, and to perhaps also run sessions exploring them, and to encourage people to subscribe.
So here on the table we've got these four lovely hardback volumes which Divan's subscribed to. What made you do that?
Well, the hardback copies are very beautiful, with Dhammarati's beautiful designs. They invite me to read them, me personally. How about yourself?
Well, I'm very fortunate. My generous friend Joala Marlini bought me a subscription, so I'm receiving the paperback and the e-back of each book as it comes out.
I've actually made a resolution to read each volume as it comes out, so I've read these four volumes, and it's had a really big impact, I'd say. I've revisited aspects of Sangharakshita's writings that I haven't read for 25 years. And I've read things that, for some reason, I didn't ever get round to reading. Mm. And it's encouraged me to notice just the breadth of Sangharakshita's approach to the Dharma, as well as its depth.
That's been such a thing for me, realising with these volumes coming out, we've got the opportunity to preserve that breadth and that depth of Sangharakshita's teachings. He offers so many different ways in, and at particular times one or other is more fashionable or popular. But actually we need to preserve that whole, that in its entirety, because in the future people might need a different approach that we're just not very interested in at the moment.
So what we've been doing at the Bristol Buddhist Centre is running study centres, a series of three afternoons to study each volume, each of the last three volumes, and we've got another set of three afternoons coming up this autumn. And for each one we've devised a set of extracts which allows the people who come along to engage in like the highlights of each volume.
And yeah, we've had a lot of fun putting those together because we both have our own interests and enthusiasms, and we've been friends a long time, but we come at things a bit differently. So we've each chosen extracts and we brought them together, and then when we're exploring them, we've definitely got meetings of different minds with Sangharakshita's mind, with those present, just exploring how do we put this into practice in our actual daily lives.
So we want to encourage others to run something similar at your local Buddhist centre. So we've made these extracts available on the Windhorse Publications website.
Yeah. And we do also want to encourage others not only to read the books, but also to subscribe. There are flyers around, there's plenty of information on the Windhorse Publications website. And with a subscription, you just pay an annual amount and you receive the volumes as soon as they're published. And that's a benefit not only to you, but there's also supporting the project in a way that's going to make sure these volumes get into print for future Dharma fairers.
And Priyananda says to remind people that you could consider buying a subscription for a friend or another Buddhist centre.
So, do you have a think about reading the books and subscribing?
And thanks for watching.
Thank you.